Greetings everyone, and welcome back to my channel once again. It's Mack. So to those who have already subscribed to my channel on my YouTube channel here, once again, thank you very kindly. As always, very much greatly do appreciate your subscription to my channel and your support. It does help my channel out in the long run of things, and very much always do greatly appreciate your support. Once again, do keep that up. It's greatly helpful and appreciating. To those who are new to my channel, please be sure to hit the like, subscribe, and the bell button so you don't miss out on anything. And share this video with other people who would like and dive into this type of content. That would be greatly appreciating. Thank you very kindly. So once again, for this Terminator Resistance enhanced gameplay content, I'm taking this type of action gameplay content into a different direction. I've already played this on my Twitch channel, and I'll link that into the description below. Since I have expanded myself to do live streaming gameplay action on my Twitch channel, please and thank you as well do extend that helpful support and follow me on my Twitch channel, which is, my username is McKellar0007. From there you'll be able to see, you know, like my gameplay action on live stream and see me on camera as well. Once again, that would be very much greatly appreciating, and I thank you all very much for that type of kind support. As for the new direction type of a gameplay action on Terminator Resistance Enhanced here, since I've already, you know, had done the live stream action on my Twitch channel, downloaded the video and uploaded it onto my YouTube channel here, this type of action gameplay on Terminator Resistance Enhanced is another DLC which is taking this type of gameplay action into a different direction. I've already played as a Terminator machine in Terminator Infiltration mode. Now I'm switching gears. This is where the new DLC comes into this. It's new, different, and separate. I do understand this type of DLC has been out for, you know, like a long while now, but I'm just going to do my own piece on this, just, you know, for the fun and hell of things. So for this direction, I'm once again going back to playing this game here, this DLC, as...
Jakub, how is Pasadena? You know what? Forget I asked. I don't want to know. I'm just glad that you're all right. Jakub, I didn't see you there.
Sergeant Rivers, you were requested by John Connor to lead the Alpha Team. You will be responsible for carrying out the attack on the location of Skynet's Central Core.
Jakub Rivers. Throughout the entire gameplay and story mode as it is, Jakub would either be doing some missions and fighting against various types of Terminator machines, either solo...
I see you're getting close to the parking lot. Look for a red van. The code reader should be inside.
How do you know I'm getting closer?
There are still plenty of resistance sensors in the area. I see everything. I'll be your eye in the sky.
Great. Now, all I need is the battery. Alvin, I'm halfway there.
Well, that's not quite true. Once you get the code reader working, you still have to find an HK to connect to. But don't worry, I'm sure they call them hunter-killers just for intimidation.
I've got the code reader working.
Good. Now go look for an HK. During the attack, our team heavily damaged an HK tank. That's your safest bet, but be careful. The area is filled with Terminators. If I were you, I'd sneak past them.
We've got a problem. That HK is still functional. I can't get near.
Rocket launcher to even make a dent in that thing. You better find one.
Got it.
I'm trying to analyze its weakness. Okay. Its power supply is located on its back. Shoot it. Hurry. Skynet's reinforcements are starting to show up.
Got it. Moving out.
Or with a team like a platoon, a squadron, or an entire army full of TechCom soldiers battling against various types of Terminator threats.
Good to see you, Sergeant.
What's the status?
We've got a defensive perimeter set up just down the road.
Doesn't seem to be working.
Skynet dropped reinforcements behind their backs. Now they're between a rock and a hard place.
All right, we need to reach our guys. Let's clear the way.
Having said that, yes, Jakub has fought various, fought against various Terminator machines alongside Jessica Baron's TechCom unit.
Skynet's coming. We're not done here yet, Rivers. Take this plasma. You're a resistance soldier. Time to act like one. This was an ambush! They knew we were coming!
How did they know?
With the Annihilation line getting closer, they must have eavesdropped on our conversation. We're on their radar now.
Watch out!
Take cover! No!
Oh!
And the highly well-known ultimate leader of the entire human resistance, John Connor himself.
Sergeant Rivers, it's time. I want you to take a team of my soldiers and fight your way to Skynet's defense grid. We have to destroy those turrets to get to the TDE, but don't worry. We'll provide the support. It's in your hands now, Rivers.
Sector is secured.
All right, Rivers. Continue the offensive. Preparing to send in the tank.
Watch out!
Zero in on that T-47!
another sector cleared.
That's good to hear, Sergeant. The HK tank just went online. You've gotta keep going.
Aerial!
Down it! Perfect timing! T-47 ahead!
Two of them!
Sergeant, I got a visual on the defense grid turrets.
This Terminator Resistance Enhanced DLC, I'm sure all of you do recall. This area right here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this part of the area does look rather familiar, especially in the early part of the game here. Yes, this is the area where Jakub does a mission within, like, this area here called Rules of Survival. Just a brief little moment here. I have to do here. Okay, so now, okay, picture this in your mind. This area is the same area / level where Jakub performs his duty in a mission called Rules of Survival. And Jakub does a separate mission still within this area here, but like that mission of his is going to take him within this same area. At night. As all of you can see, I'm just gonna quickly get down over here. So pretty much as all of you can see from this part of this whole, well, this entire area anyways, so just gonna come up over here. So as all of you can see, same area. Now, as you can tell, it's at night while he's on a separate mission called Hunting Season. Now, within hunting season, just going to bring up the map here very briefly. Now, there are two points within the whole main type of story, a part of the whole mission of the game here. You can reach at two points, one out of two. Up right here, where pretty much where Jakub is, up here, or way down here. So either way, for you to get to the whole turning point of the docks, it's not going to matter either one way or the other. You know, it's going to take you directly to the docks anyways. Now, one second here. So, just to kind of show off for the whole part of the whole demonstration, or entire demonstration anyways, I'm pretty sure all of you will be able to get the picture on this all the same. Going to enter into this building here, way down there. So once you do get to going down towards this passageway area here towards that turning point. So again, it's either going to be on the map, either down here. But considering the fact that you know we're already here at this part of the section here, this is going to be the whole demonstration which I'm about to show all of you here. Pretty much what's going to happen here is that now you can either go down this part of the pathway here or the other one, doesn't really matter. So what's going to happen here is that once you do reach that turning, the whole turning point, and you do engage that T-800 Terminator Infiltrator.
Rivers, you saw it. Is it the same model? Is it the Infiltrator?
I can't tell.
We're waiting for your signal.
I think that might be it.
You think?
Good enough for me.
Cease fire! Target down! I repeat, target down!
Go check him!
Eyes on the target. Proceed with caution.
Is he dead?
What the fuck? Is this the target?
It can't get away. Fire at will.
He's in the open.
It's in the open. It's a fucking machine.
We got it. We finally got it.
Good job, Rivers. Stay there. We're on our way.
And prior to proceeding onward with the game at this point here, when John Connor, who is just like on that radio, just like right there, gives you like the next mission to seek out Dr. Mack within the Hollywood Hills.
I still have to run some tests, so for now I would say no.
We need some more time, Connor.
I know you don't want to hear this, Commander, but if there's one person who can help us, it's Dr. Mack.
Mack? We don't even know if he's alive.
He is. He's in the Hollywood Hills. We knew a time would come when we'd need him again, so we've kept an eye on him.
You've been watching him without telling me?
Let your emotions cloud your judgment before, Commander. That's why I decided that Mac's whereabouts were no longer
this
your
is
concern.
Bullshit. He can't just magically fix all of our problems. He's a man, not a god. A man that
That's
makes
enough,
mistakes.
Commander.
You know what happened last time. He's the reason Perry's dead.
I said that's enough. Sergeant Rivers?
Yes, sir.
TechCom believes that being marked for termination is a badge of honor. Sign that we're doing something right. We wear it proudly. And knowing you're wearing such a badge, Rivers, is all I need to trust you with handling this mission. Commander Barron will fill you in on the details. Good luck, soldier. Over and out.
Looks like you're going to Hollywood Hills. Dr. Edwin Mack is the one who taught us how to use Skynet's weapons, so there's a chance he can do it again. Take him that second-generation plasma rifle and see if he's able to reprogram it. If we want to use Skynet's weapons, we need to bypass their encryption lockouts.
How will I find him?
He's obsessed with surveillance. So when you get there, look for any cameras, biometric sensors, or any other tech stuff. He should be around. That's it.
There is a separate mission slash story that happens directly after you take down the Terminator infiltrator and prior to this moment in time within Alvin's lab here and Baron's shelter here. And, well, as I have already had indicated before, prior to prior to Connor, who speaks to Rivers on the radio and giving you the next mission to seek out, you know, Dr. Mack within the Hollywood Hills. This is where the latest Terminator Resistance Enhanced DLC comes into this. According to this new and separated mission provided directly from this man right here, John Connor. John puts Jacob onto a separate DLC type of a mission. This mission, which Connor here directs and provides Rivers, will have him team up with three different soldiers. It's going to be a four-person mission. Regardless if you are performing, you know, tasks alone.
Nothing so far. Ariel!
Two of them. We need to clip their fucking wings.
Where are they heading?
I can see them touching down at what looks like a refueling station. You could try sabotaging it if you're up for it. I'm sure Pharaoh and Evans would appreciate that. You've got that HK refueling station in front of you.
Roger that.
Destroying those plasma containers will ground those HKs. Down substantially.
Or you are fighting against Terminator machines with your team.
What's going on?
What the fuck was that?
I don't know, but we're not staying here to find out. Let's go!
Find some cover! Evan!
Why the hell didn't my explosives go off?
All right, everyone on me! Rivers, get that door open!
Armored Spider, 12 o'clock! Whoa! Scratch that!
Everyone focus! Next time that could be one of us!
Stay down!
Time to go! We need to get to the surface, fast!
Oh, that was close!
Rivers, door!
Fuck!
Run!
out!
Keep your heads down!
Under heavy fire!
Either together or temporarily apart, you are still with this team. With this mission on this DLC, you are at the front line battling a very large number of various Terminator machines with high intensified climactic moments and suspense all within this DLC called the Annihilation Line. The three soldiers which Jakub will be fighting alongside with are Resistant Fighter and Sniper, Corporal Evans.
That group of T-600s that we destroyed yesterday is a discontinued infiltration unit. They tend to malfunction.
Resistant Fighter, Sapper, and Explosives Expert, Corporal Charlotte Farrow.
Maybe because if there's one mission that's worth pursuing, it's this one.
And the leader of this small team is a soldier as well, and John Connor's right-hand man. Here are some combined clips with Jessica Baron and a few clips from the first Terminator film to give off some major hints or dead giveaways as to whom I'm referring to.
Seems like you've been appointed a special task, alongside Kyle Reese, no less.
Come with me if you want to live.
I'm Reese, Sergeant Tetcom, BN38416, assigned to protect you. You've been targeted for termination.
He's Connor's right-hand man. Can't blame him for wanting to keep Reese close. He's a great soldier, completely devoted to the cause.
Yes, indeed. Jakub Rivers and us, the players, are having our chance to interact, work, and fight alongside with... John Connor's old man... That sounds strange to call him old man. Well, Connor's young man... Well, technically, I can't really call him young man. That makes him his kid. That doesn't even make sense either. Well, his old man... I can call him Connor's old man. I know that's kind of true, yet it sounds a little strange. Okay, old man, young, okay, whatever. This is going to sound strange, twisty, and confusing, but not only is this guy here Connor's right-hand man, this guy right here is also John Connor's father, Kyle Reese. Yeah, I know it. It sounds a little strange and comical, confusing, calling him an old man, but he's like, but he's younger. He's younger than him. That doesn't make any sense. Well, okay, I'll explain it. Anyway, like I said, yes, I know. Kyle looks much younger than John Connor. That's where the strange, twisty, and confusing part comes into the story. If you haven't watched the first Terminator film, definitely watch that, and you'll understand as to what I'm talking about. I don't know if Kyle will express anything genetic, that is, in relations to John or not, but this will be interesting to work and fight alongside this guy right here, Kyle Reese. So, as Jakub, you the player, of course, team up with Evans, Charlotte Farrow, and Kyle Reese right here. You'll be battling all kinds of challenging type of big and bulky type of Terminator machines. If you think challenging yourself up against, up against enormous and intimidating type of Terminators like the T-47, the HK tank, and the HK Aerial, just wait until you encounter the final boss fight.
That thing was an HK Centurion.
How the hell do you know that?
I saw them work on it when I was at that camp.
So, another of their weapons has come online. We're in deep shit. What was that?
Centurion!
Get into cover!
Don't worry. Don't let that HK intimidate you. As long as you are well-equipped with the right type of powered weapons, such as these.
Grenade launcher. Nice.
Now we got a fighting chance against those HKs.
Jacob, Kyle here, and along with some helpful support, you'll be able to take that particular HK down with some form of ease.
Now!
Aw, little piece of shit!
Move it!
Ah! Kill the fucker!
Okay, so now that all of you managed to get that information and all of the heads up along with it, now, without further ado, let's go ahead and kick this off, shall we? Okay, so I'm gonna go with play. Okay. Now I've already had done the Terminator Infiltrator mode. That's already been done out of the way. I've already had done that part of the DLC of playing as a T-800 Terminator Infiltrator. Now I'm gonna go ahead and switch it off with the Annihilation Line campaign. Again, it's going to be a part one, and then I'll try and get through that some parts of it as soon as I can, and then that'll be the end of it. Okay, let's go ahead and kick this off. That is fine, I'm good with that. The Annihilation Line expansion is an original story in the Terminator universe. It is a complete campaign you may experience at least as far as the hunting season request of the main campaign. Okay, so some of you already know where this takes place. Others, this is a type of DLC that's going to be, well, it's going to be taking place between two separate type of little story parts and campaigns, which is hunting season and after hunting season and just before you have to go and find that one scientist, Dr. Mack. Okay, here we go. The war has been raging as long as I have been alive. The war against the machines. It's the only way of life I've ever known. Lately, I dream that it's all over and the machines are defeated. Could that ever be our future, or is it just that, a dream? No, it'll be over. According to the story, apparently it will, the whole part of man versus machine, it's going to take about roughly 30 years until the whole war is over with. 30 years, that's ridiculous. Okay, here we go.
Dad? Dad, are you there? Can you hear me?
Echoes of the past. Okay, so I would... Now, before I do quickly proceed on with the whole story here, I was just going to mention a few things. First of all, now, the reason why I've been rather, unfortunately, absent and rather, unfortunately, delayed in doing this live stream here, the reason being, and trust me, I have a good logical reason for this, is because, one moment here. Well, first of all, I've just been... Well, I do have a full-time job right now, which I absolutely love doing. I work in the trade section as a landscaper and help lay down pavement stones. And so I'm doing that full-time. Plus, I'm also looking for a job full-time. Looking for another job part-time as well, so two of them. And I've had a part-time job for a little bit longer than full-time, but it didn't last. So now I'm on the hunt looking for a part-time job again. And let's just put it this way. Up in Canada here where I live in, it's just getting ridiculously pricey. I'm pretty sure not as nearly as pricey as some parts of the places within, such as in the States, like such as in the state of California where everything skyrocketed through the roof, but let's just say it's financially challenging up here in Canada right now. And trying to look for a second job along with my full-time job to try and make sure that either I can financially break even or at least gain some more financial surplus so I can try and smooth everything out. Let's just say that since what COVID had done to all of us, COVID messed me up hardcore, including with everyone else. I hope that Twitch doesn't take this down, a little YouTube, but I'm just kind of explaining my situation as to why I've been kind of delayed and why I've been a little bit absent, so all of you have a good logical understanding as to what I've been going through and what I've been trying to do lately. So all the same, I do appreciate all of your, you know, all of your kind type of support, including your patience on this. I thank you very kindly. It's the part that I will be able to get through this. It's just it'll take me time to get there. And I will make some future announcements along the way as well. Okay, here we go. Like I said, that's what COVID did, and now we're all going through this type of, great, how do we fix this type of BS nonsense? Okay, I better get young Jakub going. So yes, I am now messing around as young Jakub Rivers.
Jakub, can you hear me?
What is this place?
It's a school I attended before Judgment Day.
Why are we here?
You know why.
Dad, it doesn't matter.
Come on. It's your birthday. Of course it matters. Besides, you're the one always saying that you're old enough to scavenge. Well, today, you actually are.
But we're not even supposed to be here. The Resistance said Skynet was around here.
I wouldn't take everything John Connor says as gospel.
What do you have against him?
He used to be a real asshole. We went to school together. This school, actually.
You've met John Connor?
I didn't know him personally, but everybody knew about him. I guess this was just one of the schools he got expelled from. I doubt he'd remember it. Okay, it looks safe. You can follow me. You're already on your way here, aren't you?
I don't need you to babysit me, Dad.
Just get yourself over here. I need your help.
Okay, I don't know what that's about. I'm pretty sure this little note might be linked somewhere within either the Terminator films or that Sarah Connor Terminator Chronicles, whatever that show is. Speaking of which, I've only have watched that Sarah Connor Terminator Chronicle show, whatever the hell that's called. I've only have watched it like maybe once or twice, maybe. I just didn't really get into it all that much.
Were you a good student?
Not particularly.
Why am I not surprised?
Watch it.
We're becoming a bit of a smartass at Jakub's age.
Hey, Dad. I found some chemicals.
You have to dream bigger, kid. Especially today.
I'm still taking them.
I'm not gonna use those chemicals, so I don't know why I take them in the first place. Oh, there he is. Oh,
there you are. Now, let's start searching this place.
What are we even looking for?
A time capsule.
What's a time capsule?
Well, it's a box filled with letters, pictures, and other things that we buried when I was a student here.
Why did you bury it?
To preserve a piece of our lives, I guess. Since it's been in the ground this whole time, I'm hoping that it survived Judgment Day. If I'd known that the world would end just a couple of years later, I would have hidden something more useful in there. And again, no one could have predicted that.
What would you have hidden?
I don't know. A beer or something?
Maybe a gun, perhaps? After all, you're facing lower-graded Terminator machines. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and just find that time capsule that he's referring to. Right here.
Here lies history. I think I found it.
Stand back. You know, back in my day, parents used to say that they wanted to give their children more than they had growing up. Since that won't be possible for you, I'd like you to have at least a taste of what I had. Okay, let's see what we've got. Or something?
Really? A machine?
Yeah. We've got enough of those around here, don't we? Okay, what else is in there? Baseball cards, a cassette tape.
Dad, I think we should go. I really don't need anything.
How about this? I know it's not much. Happy birthday, Jacob.
That's cool. Thanks, Dad.
Oh, look at this. That's a letter I wrote to myself.
What does it say?
Future Frank. That's me. If you don't teach your son to mind his own business, I'm going to be very disappointed with you.
Ha ha. Very funny.
I'll hang on to it for later.
Fine. Let's just go. It's not safe here.
Wait, there's something else here. Now, this one says that it needs to be hand-delivered. Oh, let's see what's so important.
Dad, we don't have time for this, and it's not for you.
I doubt anyone's waiting for it.
How would you like it if a stranger read your letter?
Are you serious?
I'm just trying to follow your rules.
You know what? It's your birthday. I won't open it unless we find the proper recipient. It'll be our little project. I promise. Come here. Stay low. As soon as it comes closer, make a run for it, right?
Great, in HK.
Now go! Come on, Jacob! Stay close!
I'm right behind you!
In HK aerial.
Through here!
Keep on going there, Frankie.
Are you all right?
I'm fine. Just go.
Way out.
is where the eerie suspense comes in. Okay, I gotta really be freaking careful. Now, these are T-600s that we're facing for the first time. I'm probably gonna get myself killed, but we'll see.
Too good.
Don't worry about me. Get out of here. Understand?
But Dad...
I said get out of here. Get down into the sewers. I'll meet you there soon.
Dad?
Careful. Just about there. Okay, there we go.
I'm safe. Do you hear me? If you can hear me, please, let me know. Where are you?
Jacob!
You're hurt.
They're coming. We need to go. We're gonna be all right. Come on. Back! Move back!
Dad!
Jacob, run!
And the battle ended with him being deep fried. Well, my only guess is that the T-600s were quite popular in use, and the T-800s were not in development, let alone were they even new and deployed out yet. But that's just a guess on my end. The past melts away. It was just a bad dream. I come back to the present. My father's gone, but the world hasn't changed at all. We're still fighting Skynet. Only this time we're pushing back. We've secured the infiltrator's remains, and Alvin is studying them right now. Will his findings help us tell who's a friend and who's just wearing the face of one? Okay, so he's clearly referring to the part of a T-800 and an infiltrator. A T-800 wrapped in human living tissue, skin, hair, everything. Okay, here we go.
Sleeping on the job, I see.
What?
Can't say that it never happened to me. Oh, there they are. I knew I'd find them here. Are you okay? You were talking in your sleep.
Just a bad dream.
Baron's looking for you. We've got visitors that she wants you to meet.
Visitors?
A TechCom unit. At least what's left of it. Just a heads up. Something's going on. Everyone's walking around nervous.
Thanks.
Okay, I'm pretty sure that to those who have already already played this type of DLC before, the Annihilation line, I'm pretty sure all of you already know what's going on here. The story takes place between the events of the main campaign. At its start, we pick up with Jakub, Baron, and Jennifer at the residence. Oh, sorry, Resistance. What the hell am I talking about? Jennifer, as the Resistance have just defeated the first Terminator infiltrator and returned it to the base for study. While they wait to see if Alvin can reprogram Skynet's second generation plasma rifle, Jakub Rivers and his new team are sent on a mission at the behest of John Connor. I was about to say John McClane. What the hell? Of John Connor. A mission which could have a dramatic effect on the final battle to come. Yeah, we'll see. So in other words, John Connor is sending Jakub Rivers to join up with a new team. If you played this game, if you have played this DLC before, you know who the team is. All right, let's see here. Have a little scope around. Ryan's letter. Jen, I slipped this note in your bag because I do have one thing I'd like to tell you, but I'll be damned if I couldn't find the nerve to say it out loud. It's about Patrick when I was about... Okay, okay, we'll just skip this.
They're waiting for you. Come back later and let me know what's happening.
Jakub's cutie. Okay, I'm pretty sure we all recognize this area here. So I don't think there is anything I need to grab prior to meeting the new team.
Soldier?
Some of you will or will not recognize this person.
Huh?
This guy included. Corporal Charlotte Farrow and Corporal Evans. Okay, here we go.
I appreciate you taking us in, Commander.
I was sorry to hear about your team.
Fucking ambush. I'll write it in the report.
That can wait.
New orders have come in for you.
Excuse me?
You're moving out right away.
We just lost three men. Me and Pharaoh need some time to recuperate.
I'm afraid that's not possible. Northridge Outpost has gone silent. You need to go there, find out what happened, and...
What? Check if their radio's on? You know that Skynet's been jamming our signal.
That may be true, but you'll still need to see to this personally.
What the hell's going on, Baron?
Look, it doesn't make sense to me either. I could have sent a team of my own. They'd already be there, and we would know what went wrong.
So? Why didn't you?
Because the order's coming directly from John Connor. He insisted it be you.
Okay. So what's the plan?
Go to Northridge, find out what happened. Then escort the people there back to safety. Their withdrawal is long overdue.
Word is that you captured a new Terminator model.
That's right. An infiltration unit. Our top scientist is running an analysis on it as we speak.
Does that have anything to do with this mission?
The last we heard from Northridge was that they liberated a group of scavengers, so that's certainly a possibility.
I see.
Jakub Rivers here helped us capture the new model. He'll be joining you, along with Evans, as per Connor's request.
Okay, Rivers. So you can tell an infiltrator from one of us. What else can you do?
All right. So now I've already had a little bit of practice as to which part of the attributes I would have to put in because I have a good idea as to what I'm going to be, what kind of skills I'm going to be needing right off the bat. Go. There we go. Yep. Yep. And yep. 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 Might as well bump him up. That should be good. Trying to spread out as to what I need, so that way everything all fits in quite nicely as I go and progress in the game. All right.
A hacker. Skynet won't know what hit him. All right. Check the supply crate and gather your equipment. Looks like we're moving out soon. Get ready. We got a long drive ahead of us.
And to think, this is John Connor's dad. His father. Although at the current moment, not even he knows that. Hence why he's John Connor's right-hand man. Yep, he is. Heh, go figure, right?
I'm ready.
Rivers, a word with you. Seems like you've been appointed a special task, alongside Kyle Reese, no less. Just so you know, regardless of what happens, there's always a place for you here.
Is something wrong?
Every once in a while, an assignment comes along that nothing can prepare you for. I fear that this might be such an assignment. I hope that Connor made a wise decision selecting you for this mission. Besides, I need all the bodies I can get here. Any other questions?
What's the status on that second-generation plasma rifle?
Alvin is still working on it.
So, there's a chance he'll have that gun ready before my return.
I wouldn't hold your breath. Our professor doesn't have a stellar record when it comes to reprogramming Skynet technology. We're still looking for a spider scout he lost somewhere in the shelter.
What if he can't hack that plasma?
I don't even want to think about the alternative at this point.
Now, this is where... Okay, well... I'll save this one question for last, just for the hell of things. Who's Evans?
Who's Evans? I've never seen him before.
He joined us not too long ago. He's a survivor from another division, just like you. A sharpshooter. That's all I know, since he doesn't talk much. Which I appreciate.
Can we trust him?
He could ask me the same question about you. If you're concerned, you can always take it up with Connor. He appointed him to this mission in the first place.
Now, let's talk about, John Connor's pops, Kyle Reese.
What can you tell me about Kyle Reese?
He's Connor's right-hand man. Can't blame him for wanting to keep Reese close. He's a great soldier, completely devoted to the cause.
Did you serve together?
Yes, we did. We used to serve under Perry. Back then, we were naive enough to think that T-600 rubbers were as bad as things could get. Good times. After that, I became the field commander, and he joined the North Division. Now we only catch each other between missions. He's too busy doing special tasks for Connor. Good luck, soldier.
Okay, nice little chat with Jessica right here. Yes, you've been given a special type of task alongside Kyle Reese. John Connor's right-hand man and his future father. All right.
We're heading out already. What the fuck?
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, I might as well go ahead and get some things already up and going here. Now, the thing is, in the whole part of the, in the regional part of the gameplay story and the campaign as it is, I've already had weapons on Jakub that were much more advanced, and Jakub was ready to go, and he was far beyond ahead of the game when it comes to equipment and advanced weapons and so on. Now, Jakub's got to deal with this type of weapon, which it's like the bottom of the barrel type of a plasma weapon for him to use. Like, well, I suppose I could. So I could probably use this for now until I can get him up to like one of those first generation type of plasma weapons for him. All right, so. Could be needing plenty of that. And plenty of that. Wait, hold on. So... Yep. That was just have to do. Doesn't give me much type of weapon supplies, but whatever.
All set? Rivers, open the gate. We're moving out.
Okay, so... Gonna interact with two characters. Kyle Reese and Jennifer, and then I'll go ahead and get going here.
Any questions before we leave, Rivers?
Why do you think John Connor selected us for this mission?
He must have his reasons, he always does. To be perfectly honest, I learned a long time ago not to ask too many questions.
Why?
He's got this uncanny ability of putting the right people in the right places at the right time. That's a great skill to have when you're the commander of the entire resistance. So when John Connor vouches for you, I already know you'll do your job well.
What do you think about this mission?
In normal circumstances, I would say that the mission is straightforward. But I would have appreciated some advance warning.
But these are not normal circumstances.
Nothing is normal when Connor's involved. You're gonna learn that very soon.
What do you think about the team?
Corporal Farrell's a good fighter. I've been working with her for years. You and Evans? I'll wait until I know you better. But I'll postpone the introductions till we're on the road.
Okay, we've already had our own little interaction for the first part of the things with Kyle Reese. Now go up to Jennifer here, chat with her for a little bit. Jacob's a little cutie.
So, how did it go?
I'm joining Kyle Reese. We're moving out right away.
I thought that was him. So what's he like?
He seems strict.
I've heard that about him. But if him being strict makes you return in one piece, then I'm all for it.
What were you looking for back there?
Just some toys. Aaron wants to prep a field hospital for the children, so she asked me to grab whatever I can. She's hoping to bring some normalcy to the shelter. Ever since they brought that machine in, everyone's been on edge. Why do you ask?
That toy soldier looked familiar.
Do you want me to put it aside so that other kids don't play with it while you're out? I can do that. Just say the word.
So, what's on your mind?
Yeah. I wanted to ask you. You trust those guys, right? You stood face to face with that Terminator. So you'd recognize if something was wrong? I'm sorry. I shouldn't be putting any ideas in your head. It's the atmosphere around here lately. I think it's getting to me, too.
They're waiting for me.
Take care, Jacob.
That's funny as hell, especially the way that Jennifer here right away it mentions, like, I thought that was him. I thought that was Kyle Reese. And already some people are kind of glamorizing Kyle as though he's supposed to be some kind of a public figure. I figure, like, during these dark times, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, all that social media online platform, they're all gone, and he's a public figure. That's hilarious. I'm pretty sure he doesn't really kind of think about that little and have time for that. Okay. Alright, let's just get going here. Okay. We're headed to Northridge to investigate why their outpost has gone silent. However, the team is led by Sergeant Kyle Reese, Connor's right-hand man, so there's got to be something more at play here. I'm curious to hear the opinions of the rest of the squad. Evans doesn't seem like much of a talker, so maybe Corporal Farrow would be a good place to start. And on top of that, Corporal Farrow was also had like a little bit of a like a bit of a cameo type of appearance in the first Terminator film when both Reese and Farrow were trying to challenge and take down that giant type of HK ground tank. Not to give off any spoilers, but yeah, wink wink. Here we go.
We're approaching Northridge.
All right. It's a good time to bring everyone up to speed. This is a rescue mission, as simple as it gets. We go in, secure the perimeter, and prepare the evacuation. I don't want anyone to draw Skynet's attention. We're not prepared for that. We keep our heads down and evacuate those people to safety.
What if there's no one to evacuate?
Care to elaborate, Corporal?
Outposts don't stay silent for that long. If no one's been reporting in, I'd expect to find the remains of a massacre, sir.
I think introductions are in order. The Eternal Optimist sitting next to me is Corporal Farrow, an explosive specialist. Sergeant Rivers and I have already been introduced. What about you, Evans? What's your story?
I've read your file. You're the sole survivor from the 113th, right?
113th? I've heard about it. How'd you manage to escape?
Supposedly he took down a T-800 with his bare hands.
That's impossible.
That's what I'm saying.
Is it true? Did John Connor select us for this assignment?
That's right.
I'd like to meet him. Come
complete the mission and you just might. We're getting close. Get ready.
This is where the fun begins.
Northridge is up ahead. Evans, give us the sit-rep.
No signs of any resistance soldiers at the gate.
Not good.
Three T-600 approaching 1 o'clock.
T-600? They're still around?
Let's not get sloppy. We don't know what's behind that gate. This is a TechCom mission. I want us to move fast. I want us to be efficient. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now let's clear the area. Evans, you want to start us off?
Affirmative.
Everyone on me!
Target acquired. Target down.
Eyes open!
Coming in hot!
Drones.
I see them.
Evans, container.
Target acquired.
Running low on ammo.
Keep firing. Opening the gate. More hostiles inside.
Where the hell is everyone? There's no one here. No bodies, no nothing.
Let's move. We need to get to the basement. That's where they'd have taken their stand. If anyone's left alive, they'll be there.
There's more of them here!
Evans, you stay there and watch for reinforcements.
Understood.
Pharaoh sounds funny when she says that.
Stay down!
God, I'm sorry, that's just hilarious when she does that.
This way! Alright, everyone get ready. Two in front!
Down they go!
Stay frosty. We don't want to shoot friendlies.
If there are any friendlies left alive.
What the fuck is going on, Sergeant? Where is everyone?
Let's clear the area first. We'll figure it out later. Barrel, watch the flank. Enemies coming from the left.
Got you covered!
Keep firing! Watch the flame!
Fucking
just
tin
like
cans!
That.
Rivers, you see that door?
On it.
Nope.
Step back!
Haven't seen that rubber face in a while.
That's the last one. Evans, how's it looking on your side?
That's all of them.
Then secure the perimeter.
What do we do now?
We need to report this. Find a radio station and keep your eyes open.
Yes, sir.
All right. Time to collect some stuff that I'll need here. Excuse me.
No bodies? This doesn't make any sense.
All right, we'll keep going. Okay, I'm gonna try and breeze through some stuff here as quickly as I can here.
Radio station here.
Scoping out everything with a fine-tooth comb. Oh, just want to make sure I got everything, that's all. Okay, before I do that, there's something I will need to do up here. Hopefully I don't kind of get a little bit ahead of myself and skip something, because that can always happen. I've never really used those at all, so it's like, I don't even know why I keep it with me, seriously. Alright. Now I'm just gonna drop down here because... Boom. That's why. I know when it comes to using any type of weapon or sniper rifle or anything like that, I'm not gonna lie, I, you know, I know I have a pretty good dead eye for something like that. Not the kind of person that would brag myself about that, but at the same time, you know, it's quite beneficial to have. And shotgun. Now, according to the type of Terminator machines I will be using, I'll probably end up selling that off anyways, because I know for a fact I'm most likely just not gonna be using a shotgun. I just feel as though, like, according to the upcoming type of challenges of these type of really strong and powerful type of Terminator machines, I literally don't think there's any point of having a shotgun with me. Lower grade of kind, well, I'm not gonna lie, that will help, yes. Upper kind, like T-800 and up, no. There's no point to that. Okay, well, before I do that, I don't think there's anything for me to grab here. I'll be surprised if there would be, but I doubt it. Whoops. I don't think I'll be able to get up there. See what I need to grab here. Mentioned. So I managed to grab everything from that section there. Like I said, there's always a minor little something. Right.
Comms. This should be it.
I don't think so. Keep on forgetting, was there anything I would need to grab out of here? I'm thinking not, but no, it should be okay. Alright, let's get on the comms and let's go ahead and turn the page, so to speak.
Sergeant, found a radio station upstairs.
I understand you're not happy with the situation, but for now you'll have to stay put. At least until I discuss your next move with Connor. Is that clear?
Yes, Commander. awaiting further instructions.
Over and out.
All right. Looks like we're turning in for the night. I understand that not everything went as planned today. There are still a lot of unanswered questions here. But for now, get some rest. Tomorrow will be when the real work starts.
Yes, sir.
Rivers, do you have a moment? I need to talk to you about your performance today.
Sir.
Each of us has been selected for this mission because we all have something to contribute. When we don't do our part, people die. That's what happened during my previous assignment. So I need you to be more focused. Is that understood, Rivers?
Yes, sir.
Can't help it if I have ADHD. Oh. So, we've reached Northridge, and it appears to be abandoned. No bodies, no signs of fighting, nothing. It's like all the people that lived there just vanished, but where could they have gone? Lots of questions and no answers yet. The best we can do now is to investigate the outpost and find some clues. Okay, so what I will do just for now anyways here, because I know there's going to be more progress going to be going on as I have Jakub here within the area here. So what I'm going to do just for now anyways, hopefully this works anyways. By the time I get back here, I would still be able to still have Jakub in this spot. I could be able to continue with the progress. So having said that, I'm going to pretty much just... stop the progress of the video right here, and I will be able to continue on with this type of progress here around this area of this type of campaign or the story here at a later date and time. Okay, so besides that, everyone, thank you very kindly for tuning on to my channel once again here. This is Mac. So by all means, be sure to follow me on both Twitch and on my Twitch channel right here and my YouTube channel as well. So if you have any comments or questions, by all means, go ahead, just throw it down in the comment section and like and subscribe as always. That's great. And that's always greatly appreciated, and the great support is always great. Thank you very kindly, and I'll be back soon and to continue on with a nice little story here. Peace out, stay gold.